paintings.
IRS, I'm going to help you.
Yes, I just got a call from this phone number.
Just verify your phone number that you had received a missed call or a message.
201-367.
Let me check, just give me a moment. Okay, I believe I'm speaking to Donald.
Yes, you are.
Donald, there is a lawsuit being filed against you by the Internal Revenue Service.
Uh-huh.
And it is a legal action taken by the Supreme Courthouse for your taxes.
Oh, what do you mean? I don't understand.
Yeah, listen, there is a lawsuit being filed against you by the Internal Revenue Service, and it is a legal action.
Why?
It is a legal action taken by the Supreme Court House.
Uh-huh.
For your taxes. Okay, for your taxes.
What do you mean? What was wrong with my taxes?
Okay, and there is an arrest warrant on your name. After 2 hours, the arrest warrant will be released on your name. Your driving license will be cancelled. Your social security will be blacklisted, and your banking account will be seized. Okay, after 2 hours. Now, can you just grab a pen and paper in your hand? Then I can just provide you some information about your case.
Well, I'm a little shaken here. What was wrong with my taxes?
Can you just grab a pen and paper in your hand? Then I can just provide you some information first, okay? Then I can assist you further, okay?
Oh, okay, hold on. I'll get one real quick. Hang on. Hold on. Okay, can I use a crayon?
Let's go back. It's on you.
What? Okay. All right, go ahead.
All right, my name is Officer David Gomez.
What was your name?
My name is Officer David Gomez. My last name is Gomez. G-O-M-A-Z. Gomez.
Gomez?
That's correct.
With a G?
O-M-A-Z. Gomez.
G-O-M-E-Z. What was your first name?
That's correct. Okay.
What was your first name?
My first name is David. D-A-V-I-D. David.
David. David Gomez. Okay, David.
That's correct, okay. All right, just write down my batch ID number. My batch ID number is IRM.
IRF.
M as in member, not F.
A as in Amber.
Listen, I as in internal, R
okay.
as in revenue, M as in member, number
okay.
two.
Okay, all right, so
number one.
ICM then.
I-R, as in Romeo.
I-R.
M, as in Mary.
A-
number two.
A-M, M, I-R-A-M.
Number
right?
two.
Two. Do,
two
I write,
one, four.
Do I write the word number?
That is correct. 214.
Okay. N-U-M-B-E-R. Two. Okay.
14.
14. Okay. I think I got it.
Okay. Now,
do you want me to read it back?
Help me out. That's correct.
You want me to read it back?
That's correct.
Okay.
Just repeat it.
All right. IRAMNUMBER 2411.
That's correct.
Okay. I got it.
Okay. Now, just confirm your address, okay? Your address is... That's correct?
What? No, it's not Douglas.
Just confirm your address. Yeah, that's correct?
Okay. Well, it's DID.
All right, and is it,
it's correct.
That's correct. That's correct. Okay. And your zip code is? That's correct.
Well, that sounds right.
Okay. Now, just helping out with your date of birth, to pull up your case paper on my system, then I can just provide you your case number, then I can assist you further with your legal matter. Just helping out with your date of birth.
My date of birth? You don't have it?
That's all right. Just helping out with your date of birth, to pull up your case paper on my system, then I can just provide you your case number, then I can assist you further with the legal matter, okay? Just helping out with your date of birth.
Okay, January 17, 1973.
Okay, can you repeat the date of birth once again?
Mm-hmm. Me or you?
For me.
For you. I don't know your birthday. No.
Just repeat your date of birth once
my
again,
date of
okay?
Birth. Oh, you're confusing me. I'm so shaken right here. I don't know. I'm sorry. Hang on. It's January
17, 1973. Okay. Now, I will just go ahead and read out some legal charges against you.
Okay.
Now, can you just write down your case number? Okay, let's write down your case number first, okay?
Your
case number is C as in Charlie.
The word Charlie?
Yeah, C as in C as in Charlie.
C-C.
H as in hotel.
S as in hotel. That doesn't make any sense.
H as in hotel. H as in house.
H?
Etch.
What's etch? I don't know what etch is. Etch like
as in hotel.
Like etch a sketch.
Horse.
Etch?
Like you can say horse. Horse.
I'm sorry. I don't know what an etch is.
Listen.
Yes. I'm listening.
C.
I'm sorry.
Just
I'm
write
very,
down C.
I'm C.
Just write down C.
C.
Number seven.
Seven.
Six.
Six.
Two,
five, nine. Got it.
Okay, this is your case number. All right. Now I will just go ahead and read out some legal charges against you.
Okay.
But before that, these lines are getting recorded and monitored by the IRS headquarter and the jury member of the courthouse. So do not interrupt me.
Of the what house? Of the what? Did you say goat house?
Supreme Court House. Supreme Court House.
Supreme Goat House. I'm sorry, I don't follow. You're really confusing me. Listen, I'm really nervous here. I don't need to get arrested, and you're really confusing me.
Listen. Now, I will just go ahead and read out some legal charges against you.
Uh-huh.
But before that, this line are getting recorded and monitored by the IRS headquarter and the jury member of the courthouse. Do not interrupt me.
Yes.
Courthouse. Court.
G-O... What? Gort?
C-O-U-R-T. Court. Courthouse.
Oh, courthouse.
Courthouse.
Courthouse. I'm sorry.
Courthouse.
Listen, it really sounded like you were saying goat house. It was really confusing me.
Courthouse for your taxes. Listen, while I'm saying you. Now, this call has been regarding by this federal courthouse. Okay? Once I complete my part, I will give you a chance to raise your question, okay?
Sure.
Alright, as per the document, we conducted an audit on your tax file for the year of 2009
till
2012.
Okay.
And we found that there was a miscalculation error and the tax that your file doesn't match the tax record that we have.
Uh-huh.
So according to Section 101, that amount is still outstanding on your name that you have not paid.
Okay.
For the reason, the local sheriff officer will come at your place with your arrest warrant, your driving license cancelled, everything under your name, property, your banking account will be seized, and everything under your name, your property, your banking account will be seized, and also face federal imprisonment for up to 5 years. Now the total balance outstanding on your name is $7,900, which includes your pending tax, your legal charges, and late fees. Now, can you just let me know that, did you do this intentionally or was it by mistake to defraud IRS?
Did I do what intentionally?
To defraud to IRS.
Why would I defraud the IRS?
Alright. Like, now you have two options. Either you go with your attorney at the federal courthouse or light case with us, or you can resolve this case outside the courthouse. What you want to do? Because you have only 2 hours to cancel your arrest warrant. After 2 hours, the arrest warrant will be released on your name. And if you want to resolve this matter, if you want to resolve this case right now, then I can just transfer this call to my senior representative, and he will be helping you out to cancel the arrest warrant.
You said that I'd have a chance to ask a question after you did all that. Can I ask? Am I allowed to?
Yeah.
Because I just want to clarify. What was the amount that I still owe, and how much did I how much did I pay? Initially,
$7,900. You want to pay $7,000. Now, the outstanding balance is $7,900.
What was
which include your pending tax?
Yeah.
Listen, which includes your pending tax, your legal charges, and late fees.
Yeah. Okay. How much did I pay initially?
$7,900.
No, but
you want to go to the IRS right now?
That's what I listen. This is my question. If I owe $7,000 and change, how much did I pay at the time that I owe $7,000 and change? What did I initially pay the IRS? Just so I know.
That's all. Listen, what I'm saying, you know.
Uh-huh.
Now, like, you have two options. Okay, you can go, you have two options. Either you go with your attorney at the federal courthouse or fight case with us, or you can resolve this case outside the courthouse. What you want to do, okay? What you want to do. If you want to resolve this matter outside the courthouse, then I can just transfer this call to my senior representative, and he will be helping you out to cancel your arrest warrant, all right? And he will help you out to resolve your matter outside the courthouse. Now, can you just let me know what you want to do? You can fight this case inside the courthouse against the IRS, or you can resolve this matter right now. Because you have only 2 hours, to cancel your arrest warrant. Okay?
I understand that, but you told me you would answer a question, and you haven't. I'm really worried here, and I want to make sure I have all these facts straight, because I want to make sure that I don't get arrested.
All right, Now, just let me know what you want to do. If you want to resolve this matter right now, or if you want to find this case. If you want to resolve this matter, just let me know, and I can just transfer this call to my Treasury Department officer, and he will be help you out further, okay?
I would love to resolve this now.
All right, do you have $7,900 to itself to resolve this matter outside the courthouse?
Of course I do.
All right, Just do one thing, just be online for a moment. Now, I will just transfer this call to my senior representative, and he will be helping out to cancel your arrest warrant, and he will be helping out to resolve this matter outside the courthouse. Just be online for a moment, okay?
Sure.
Thank you for holding the line, and thank you for your patience. This is Senior Officer John Dawson from Crime and Investigation Desk of Internal Revenue Service.
I'm sorry, what was your last name again?
Dawson. It's D as in David, A as in Alpha, yes.
W
as in Whiskey, S as in Sam, O as in Oscar, N as in November.
Okay, got it. I'm sorry, what was your first name, Mr. Dawson?
John. It's J as
John.
In...
John.
Dawson.
John. John Dawson.
That's right.
Okay.
And I'm from the Crime and Investigation Desk of Internal Revenue Service.
What's the crime in? What's crime in?
Crime.
Crime.
It's not crime in.
Well, you said
crime.
I'm sorry. I swear you said crime in. Crime, okay.
Crime and Investigation Desk.
Okay.
So I believe that my officer already explained to you the consequences.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I didn't speak to Rudy. I spoke to a David.
Did my officer explain to you the consequences about your pending taxes? Did David explain you?
Yeah, David said that you guys made a mistake and that you actually owe me more money on my taxes.
You guys? We owe you money?
Yeah, they said that you were looking back between 2009 and 2012, no, and you showed that I paid more. We owe the money. Yeah,
we owe the money to you.
He said that
we have to pay the money to you.
Correct. He said that I paid too much money and that I'm owed $7,000 in change. I swear that's what he said, because I got really excited when he told me that.
Yeah, there's one thing. Just go and kill yourself.
Hello?
Yeah, just go and kill yourself.
What? What?
Go and kill yourself.
Why?
Go and kill yourself.
Why? Listen, it's really easy.
You are a waste. It's easy.
You can just go get a GE money card. Or you can go to Western Union and you can send me the money. It's really easy. I'll tell you how to do it. You just go to a Western Union. Do you have a Western Union nearby? Or
just
a Walmart?
And
you can go in there. You go to like a Walmart or a Western Union, and you go in there, and you buy the money pack card, and you just put the money on there and send it to me. And then I got the money that you guys are going to send me. I can tell you how to do it. Is there a Western Union nearby?
All right. Back a pardon.
Is there a Western Union near you?
Internal Revenue Service?
No.
Hey, you son of a bitch. I told you to shut your mouth and disconnect the line.
No, you didn't say that. You told me to kill myself.
Hi, IRS. How can I help you?
Hi.
Hi.
What's going on, man?
Everything is great, man. What's about you?
Oh, just chilling, bro. What you doing?
I'm just scamming you.
Oh, you're scamming me. Oh,
now, I was thinking for scamming you, but you know that this is a scammer. That's why I will not scam you right now.
Oh, you won't scam me? Why not?
Yeah.
Why not?
Because I want to go for a toilet, that's why I will not scam you.
Oh, okay. Hey, listen. My name is Don, but what's your first name?
My first name is Donor Riemann.
No, I'm being candid with you, man. I'm just with two guys talking man to man. Like, obviously, I know your name's not David or whatever. That's silly. But what is your name?
David is not my name. I'm not David.
I realize that. That's obvious. But I'm just, like, we're talking right now, like, I'm a man, you're a man, we're both men, right? So, I'm Don. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
I'm Miller. Nice to meet you, too.
I'm sorry. I didn't quite catch that.
Miller Mattis.
Miller? Nah, come on. That ain't your name. Come on. Okay, Miller. I'll play along. Why do you do this? Why do you do this?
For money.
Yeah, but obviously you don't make all this money that you scam. Somebody else makes it, right? And they pay you, right?
Listen, I want to go for the toilet, Ronald. Bye-bye, have a great day.
No, don't go, man. Don't go. You're like my new friend.